हॅलो स्टुडंट, वेलकम अगेन. आय एम डॉक्टर चौधरी यजी फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मायक्रोबायोलॉजी, व्यंकटेश महाजन सिनियर कॉलेज उस्मानाबाद. इन दिस व्हिडिओ वी आर गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस यू युअर पेपर नंबर 8 ऑफ सेमिस्टर 3, दॅट इज इम्युनॉलॉजी. वी आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द पेपर नंबर 7, दॅट इज एन्व्हायरमेंटल मायक्रोबायोलॉजी. सो इफ there are any changes in the syllabus due to the COVID pandemic condition in both paper, timely I will inform it to you. If you have any doubt about my videos, then note it in comment section, or any suggestions, you must note it in your comment section. So let us introduce your paper number 8, immunology. It is also of 4 unit as that of environmental microbiology. So in this video, we will discuss your immunology paper. So first unit is of notobiology. It is the condition of germs, that is germ-free animal. It consists of normal flora and human beings. Normal flora of the human beings, particularly these are the commensal microorganisms that are live in association with the human being and forms a part of defense mechanism of that particular person. So all openings starting from skin, all openings, nose, ear, eyes, and up to the intestinal tract, vaginal tract, all these are having their own microflora and having their own role. The well-known example is lactic acid bacteria that reside in the intestinal tract and that maintain the digestive tract conditions. Okay, then next one is defense mechanism of host. So not only the normal flora, other cells and organs are also having their own role in the defense mechanism, exterior defense mechanism, interior defense mechanism. So we will discuss it later on. Then non-specific factors, physiological barrier, natural, cellular and humoral factor. So which type of chemicals are secreted against particular entering pathogens, which type of cells are inducted during eclecting the immune response, or which types of factors are secreted, that is the humoral factors, whether it is antibody, whether it is interleukin, whether it is phagocytin, which type of factors are eclected during the maintaining immune response, that are studied during under this point. Then aggressive factor, which particular mechanism is involved in maintaining the immune response. So we will discuss in detail while studying. The next point is infection. In that, the definition with example of primary infection, secondary infection, cross infection. Primary infection is the infection that is for first time, and secondary infection is when the organism, same organism, infect for second point. Examples बघायचं झालं तर आपण टायफॉइडचा रिओकरन्स बघू शकतो. प्रायमरी जेव्हा इन्फेक्शन असेल तेव्हा ते हजार्डस असू शकतं, पण जेव्हा सेकंडरी ते इन्फेक्शन होतं तेव्हा आपली इम्युन सिस्टीम त्याला नोन असते. सो इट विल हेल्प इन डिफेंडिंग दॅट एंटरिंग पॅथोजन. अँड क्रॉस इन्फेक्शन, इट इज द इन्फेक्शन ऑकर्ड ड्युरिंग हॉस्पिटलायझेशन कंडिशन. पेशंट एका कंडिशननी हॉस्पिटलमध्ये ॲडमिट आहे आणि त्याला दुसऱ्या टाईपचं इन्फेक्शन झालं तर त्याला क्रॉस इन्फेक्शन म्हणायचं. Then sources of infection, so ranging from where we live, that is environmental factors, soil, water, air, or food, contaminated food, and also the diseased person's contact or fomite, inanimate object, all can serve as sources of infection. Then determine infection factors, how infection is established, what is antigenicity, what is virulence factor, what are the symptoms, what is the incubation period, all these are the conditions that we have to study under this point. Then mode of transmission of disease. Mode of transmission of disease, it is through air, through water, through soil, or it may also indicate the route of entry, that is a nasopharyngeal region, through nose. Also the mode of transmission also indicates whether the disease is vector borne, whether the disease is food borne, whether the disease is through fomites. So different modes are there for transmission of disease. Then process of infection, entry and spread out in the host body. So where from the organism infect, where from it enters into the body and where it spread. For example, COVID-19 is an example dila apan. It is the airborne disease, it is a respiratory tract disease. So the entry of organism from droplet nuclei that resides through the sneezing coughing activity of the diseased person in the air, and inhalation of this droplet nuclei through nose or mouth, and their entry of this pathogen into the host body and it spread up to the lungs. So this is one of the example. So this is your first unit. Now second unit is immune system and immune responses. So what is immunology? So immunology is the branch of science that deals with the immune responses of an host. So what is immune response? When an entering foreign material enters within the body, our body elicits certain reactions against that particular pathogenic organism, and this forms your immune response. Our body reacts means what? There is certain reactions, there is secretion of certain chemicals to neutralize that infectious organisms, or cells get stimulated and there is secretion of certain neutralizing factors. So these are the immune responses against entering pathogens, and these immune responses are guarded by our immune system. So immune system, organ and cell involved, function, types of cells and function of immune system. So primary and secondary organ, jala central and peripheral pan mhatla jata, tumcha thymus ahe, bursa fabrics ahe, lymph node ahe, malt guard tissues ahet tumche. So different organs are there, different cells are there, B cell, T cell, natural killer cells, phagocytic cells, macrophages, all these are forming the part of immune system and having their own function in neutralizing the or to fight against that particular entering pathogen. Then production of antibody, this is the function of B cell and organs, bursa of Fabry cells, bone marrow, yachyamadhye ya B cells form hotat, how they are produced. Then monoclonal antibodies, so this is also a separate point. Then its regulation at genetic level and factors affecting antibody production. So how antibody are great production, what is the mean by monoclonal antibody, hybridoma technique use karun hai monoclonal antibodies produce kele jatat. Okay, so we will study detail later on while conducting your lecture. And last point is stem cell and stem cell therapy. This is the basics therapy that can be applied to the serious infections. So this is your second unit. Third unit is of immunity. So when a foreign material, which is mean antigen, a foreign material enters into the body of certain individual, it elicits immune response or it elicits the immunity. So reaction against foreign material is the immunity. So definition, classification, innate and adaptive immunity, active and passive, cellular and humoral, these are the types and subtypes of the immunity or immune responses that can be collected against entering pathogen. Innate, which is natural, adapted, which is acquired. So after entering the pathogenic organism and following disease condition is the innate, that elicit innate immunity. But when you are get immunized by particular organism, then it is adaptive immunity. So immunization program through जे acquire होते त्याला adaptive immunity म्हणायचं. Likewise active, passive, cellular, humoral, specific, non-specific, these are the types of immunity that are elicited. Then certain factors, that is complement, which is a protein in your blood, interferons, these are the particle that induced against viral infection, and this can be serve as a good gene for treating viral infection in case of COVID-19. Also this can be a good mean for treating serious patients. Then antigen is any foreign material. It is not only the pathogenic organism but chemical or toxin, any foreign material that enters within your body. So that no doubt which elicits immune response. Then definition, determinants of antigenicity, its size, its chemical nature, it may be protein, it may be lipoprotein. Okay, then susceptibility to the tissue enzyme, foreignness, it also a very important characteristics, specificity. So these are the characteristics of that antigen. Then types of antigen, species specific, certain antigens are particularly specific for certain species. Autoantigen, isoantigen, autoantigen are the antigen of that particular host. Organ specific, particular organ la infect karna nahi. MSC antigen, for example HIV virus infect to T cell only. So particular cell line specific, particular organ specific, respiratory tract diseases say lungs la infect kartat, digestive tract say intestine la infect kartat. So particular type, heteroantigenic, heterophiles antigen, antigen in relation to bacterial cell. So bacterial antigens, viral antigens, so different types are there. So we will discuss in detail. Then next point is antibody. Types of antibody, antibody are termed as immunoglobulin depending upon their chemical nature. IgA, IgG, IgM, okay, IgE and IgD, all these are the five types of antibody are there. Okay, I will repeat again, IgG, IgA, IgM, IgE and IgD. So we will discuss, make a chart for studying this antibody during our lecture. Then types of antibody, so these are the particular depending upon their functions. So my cursor is not going there. Last point is there, antitoxin, precipitin, against toxin, antibody against toxin, precipitin that having precipitation reaction, agglutinin, bacteriolysin. The names indicate itself what type of function it carried out. So bacteriocidin, bacteriotropin, complement fixing and neutralizing, these are the types of antibody. Okay, so this is your last unit, fourth one, which is antigen antibody reaction. In this unit we are particularly studying how our immune response is acted, actually the mechanism of our immune responses, particularly the antigen-antibody responses. The foreign material entered within our body is the antigen, and the factor that elicit immune response against that antigen and which is produced by our body is the antibody. So, general features of antibody-antigen reaction. What are the general characters? Okay, then mechanism, method, and applications. These are the phenomena by which this antibody-antigen reactions are activated or are carried out. First one is agglutination, precipitation, complement fixation, neutralization, immunofluorescence, and ELISA. Okay, so this particular test is used to detect the HIV virus, ELISA, enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. So we will discuss detail later on. General methods of prophylaxis. Prophylaxis means preventive measure. इम्युनायझेशन शेड्यूल आहे याच्यामध्ये तुमचा. सो टॉक्झाइट इम्युन सेरा. टॉक्झाइट्स आर द मीन्स दॅट आर यूज्ड टू ट्रीट द अगेन्स्ट द टॉक्झिन्स, टॉक्झिन्स ऑफ बॅक्टेरिया, टॉक्झिन्स ऑफ सर्टन अदर टाईप्स. सो टिटॅनस टॉक्झाइट, डिप्थेरिया टॉक्झाइट्स, ऑल दीज आर इम्युन सेरा. आर द सीरम बेस्ड इम्युन थेरपी. प्रिन्सिपल इन्वॉल्ड इन प्रिपरेशन अँड यूज ऑफ ॲडज्युएंट. देन व्हॅक्सिन्स टाईप्स ऑफ प्रिन्सिपल मेथड. व्हॅक्सिन्स नंबर ऑफ व्हॅक्सिन्स आपण बघतो. इम्युनायझेशन शेड्यूल असतो आपला. सो बेसिक जे आहे बॅसिलस कॅल्मेटेग्युरिन टॅब आहे, ओ पी आय ओरल पोलिओ वॅक्सिन आहे, देन टी टी आहे, डी पी टी आहे. डिफरंट वॅक्सिन्स आहेत, वी विल स्टडी इट लॅटर ऑन. ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ वॅक्सिन अँड इम्युनायझेशन शेड्यूल. सो इट स्टार्ट डायरेक्टली विथ अवर बर्ड, द विथ बी सी जी वॅक्सिन. सो वी विल स्टडी इट डिटेल. होप यू गेट द आयडिया अबाउट दिस पेपर अँड वॉट यू हॅव टू स्टडी. आय विल प्रेफर कुबे. इम्युनॉलॉजी बाय कुबे इज द बेस्ट बुक for your reference. No doubt I will provide you notes and I will help you in your study. So be prepared and study sincerely.